programmes. Get your match programmes in. Come on, match programmes.
Did you bring it? He's waiting outside.
I've got it, all right. What's up to him?
So, your brains are a bus. We're bound to beat Ipswich.
So, today we'll lose.
Look, Tony, it's just a bet. We're not the first.
Think about it. 100 quid. It's 3 weeks' wages. Nobody's going to get hurt.
More wages if we're caught.
We won't get caught.
You want her upstairs, Tony?
Tony?
What? Who wants me?
Put a tie on about you.
Sit down, okay, lad. Well, lad, you may as well know, we've decided to sell thee to Everton. Mr. Catrick here has made us a good offer, so there's an end to it. Today will be your last match for Wednesday. You can go now, lad. Thanks very much.
What if I don't want to leave Sheffield, eh? I'm a home-loving boy, me.
There's good homes in Liverpool, Kay.
My wife hates Scousers, Mr. Chairman. Seriously, there's the problem. She's told me so. But I go so far as to say it's a phobia. Maybe I'd best go see Players Union.
Union be buggered. You'll do as you're damn well told.
Will I?
If you don't mind, gentlemen, could I have a few minutes alone with Mr. Kay? £60 a week plus bonuses and a
80.
New 70.
80. I don't know. If we win the title.
Who's we?
You, Everton. Me, if I sign for Everton.
You get a medal. Something real. Something to hold in your hand when the cash runs out. You'll not get one here. Why do you think I left? Now, come on, Tony. Put all this behind you. Come on, play.
I want that medal, boss.
We'll get it.
Hey, one more thing.
No, whatever it is.
A jag. A shiny new one. Well, don't worry. How about myself?
Tony, will you tell me what's going on, for Christ's sake? Are you in on this or what?
Not him.
Lantern, for Christ's sake, Tony.
That blind bastard we had at Wolves.
Well?
No.
What?
I'm not doing it.
You've already placed your bet.
I said I'm not doing it. Anyway, I wouldn't know how.
They're completely supportive of me and they just wish me the best, so.
Now, many people might find it rather surprising you're the most expensive player in England and yet you haven't got an international cap. Do you think you stand a better chance of playing for England now that you're with Everton than you did when you were in Sheffield Wednesday?
Well, I'd like to hope so, you know. All I can do is play my best for Everton and things seem to be going, you know, very well there. And as I understand it, Mr. Ramsey's planning to come and see some of the games. If we keep playing well, you know, and I just look forward to 6-6, obviously.
What is it with you, Gibbon, eh?
What? What is it with you and football?
You know, it might be on your
it's personal,
all
right?
I'm sure they're thinking £55,000 is a lot of money to pay for
you ready yet?
Yeah, done it.
I think he expected to play in the best.
Yes.
Really that, you know.
One-nil.
I see you playing for England in the World Cup in 1966. Good luck. Thank you very much indeed.
Funny how I missed the bit where you carried your way through 18 pints
and sit
up on the sofa at 4 o'clock this morning. Very sparkling, that was.
Oh, give up, woman. I came home to you, didn't I?
Oh, yeah. What for?
I was homesick.
Oh, so it wasn't
the beer. Hey. Tell you what, though, it's not too bad, this. For the first game. Get off.
That's enough of that. Come on, Tony, get up.
Hey. I'm a bit keen, aren't you? Someone who doesn't want to move.
Tony, I can't go. The ex-counsel's me.
Tony, I mean it. Get up.
All right, all right. Shit.
It's just newspaper talk. You know what they're like.
Oh, yeah. Gilbert and Campley. Never heard of him.
Yeah, you know, Campley is a football man.
Well, who's Gabbett then?
Now, what do they know? I mean, bookies lose 1,000, name names. There'd be no football left if they did that.
Who was it, Bronco? Eh? This mystery man with the fantastic odds, who was it?
Just a mate, I told you.
Tell me his name.
Jimmy. Gould. Jimmy Gould.
Jesus Christ.
He's all right. I played with him at Mansfield.
Yeah, well, you see him again, you're telling from me he's all right. Dick Turpin.
A robber.
Jimmy wouldn't do that. He's a smashing bloke, honest. Listen, I'll have a word with him. See if we can sort something out.
Don't bother. Never just forget it.
Oi. Oi. You're still taking your cut, though, eh?
I just want what's mine. Nothing more, nothing less, all right? I'll see you two boys at Everton next time you come for a thrashing.
Thank you.
hate it. I could say I'm gonna hate it.
Ah, give over, woman. It's Lancashire. Bloody Africa. Hey, we're here.
There's no shops.
Oh, give me a chance. I haven't built them yet.
Kids will murder those lawns.
Will you shut up and start enjoying yourself, for God's sake?
What's he looking at?
I don't know. I'll sort him out.
Morning, Major.
God.
Oh, God. Marty! They're here!
Look at that, eh?
Where is everybody?
They're all in bed, making mad passionate love. They do a lot of that round here.
Tony! Mrs. K! On behalf of all true Everton supporters, I'd like to welcome you to Formby.
Well, I said it's not my white stick, it must be the deputy. Well, isn't it gorgeous? Isn't it the nicest house you've ever seen? Straight out of the pages of Vogue. I'm thinking of buying the one next door. Only joking. Everything's perfect, everything's brand new. Look at that, 14-inch screen. Brand new wood cut. This is for you off the boys. Nice little memento. Well, solid wood here on your fireplace. South American mahogany. Lovely sweet. If you want to change the carpet any colour, I'm sure the club will sort it out. And, of course, a bottle of bubbly to go with your own personal little bar. Now, this way, Mrs. K, if you want to have a look at your kitchen, it's got everything in. Loads of cupboard space, brand new mixer, lovely worktops, brand new cooker there, brand new fridge, American style. There you go. Make lolly ices for the children. That's sound. Now, listen, young man, come and see this garden. You think your dad's a good footballer? Wait till you see me. Come on, chuck.
Christ, Tony K, what have we done?
We made it. That's what we've done. We made it. Come here.
Not here. It's funny. Tony.
Hey, you're all right now, eh?
Tony, save your energy for the big game, lad. Come and have a look at the garden shed.
And all eyes are surely going to be on England's most expensive player, Tony Kane, the man Harry Kattrick feels could be the final piece in the jigsaw of Everton's championship-chasing side.
Here, Tony!
All right, Tony. You got me tickets, Sam.
Oh, Christ, left me over as a word, didn't I?
Come on.
Good luck, Tony. Good luck.
Yo. Hello. All right, boss, just give him go and a couple of comps for his crippled aunties, you know, she's got to sit down.
Yes. Yeah. Right, how many crippled aunties have you got?
Got loads. It's a very Catholic, very sickly family, isn't it? Auntie Bessie, Auntie Lily, Auntie Flo, Auntie Mary, Auntie Claire, Auntie Margaret. Auntie Harry. I'm a bit worried about her, actually. Auntie Fanny, Auntie Annie, Auntie Freeze. She's a cold album for that one.
I'll see you later.
All right, Tony. See you, Harry. There's one for your uncle. Tony! Have him, son! Have him!
Come on, come on, come on.
Come on,
come on. Easy, lads.
What are you? Getting a bit late,
aren't you?
You do it.
Not under the main stand, not with all the directors around.
Oh, get off.
Harry, are you playing, mate? Are you playing solid?
I don't know yet, lads. You play anywhere, this lad.
Come on, boss. You've got to think about all the money over the years.
I'm going to win today, kids. No doubt about it.
£60,000 Christmas this afternoon. Out there, wages. What do they get, eh? Pie and a pint of squash fences with an epic pissing shed. That's never got spent on them. And we never got it, that's for sure.
Score of a Saturday, that's all that bothers me.
Hey, have I let you down on the pitch, boss?
Thank you. Contestant number two, Miss Nicola Dunn. And Nicola's hair this year was styled from our Brick Road salon. Ladies and gentlemen, one of the greatest footballers that ever teams have walked in, one of the greatest signings ever made, Mr. Tony Kay. Let's hear it from Tony Kay and his lovely wife, Marina. Marina, would you like to come and join the girls? Did you get a seat there for Marina? Thank you.
Go on, Rob. I'll just get one in with the lads, all right?
See, Tony's heading straight to the bar. You missed the bar bloody often enough this afternoon, didn't you, Tony? Only joking, son. Only joking.
You see, I had a dream. I had a dream.
Oh, it's all right for you. You can bloody laugh, but I tell you what, this dream's going to come true because football's changing. The world's changing. You've got to think ahead. Like the hairdressing shops.
Just one more.
When you've got no business, you get the bloody old pensioners in, don't you?
Oh, look at these two. Shame about yours, isn't it?
Hello, ladies. What's he drink?
A baby sham.
Oh, yeah. What's a baby sham?
Bastard.
What do you want?
Look, we've got rid of the maximum wage. Next, it's going to be freedom of contract. But when that happens, they won't be just footballers. They'll be personalities, celebrities. Mm-hmm. Now, I know it'll take time, but when it happens...
You'll throw us another party.
There'll be money to be made, easy bloody money.
And I'll drink to that. Yeah.
Well, that's where I come in.
Great call, that, Tony. Great call.
Thanks a lot.
You're a footballer. Your mate's taking his time for my drink.
Yeah.
I'm a footballer.
So where's your brokering?
What?
Those old footballers wore baggy shorts and brill cream.
What's match you watch? Your granddad must have been playing.
This always happens to me.
Oi, lads, do us a favour, get a drink.
So who looks after the footballers? Who should look after the footballers? Hey, not the football manager, but their personal manager.
Excuse me, love.
So what I'm saying, girls, shall I put all your husbands under contract? Hey, I'll handle the press and the celebrity business. By the way, there'll be records and merchandising. And ain't St. John shown an interest?
Are you married?
Oh, me?
Who's your friend?
Hello, love. This is Marina, my wife. And this is Nicky. She's a big fan of Everton.
He's been telling me all about his football.
Oh? Didn't know they'd written about you in the Bunty.
Oh, this month's sensible, me.
Better go.
That's your bedtime, is it, love? You know what that is? 3 years inside.
She's 18, that one.
How do you know?
Couldn't get in here otherwise, could she?
I like Mrs. Kay. Enjoying yourself?
Yes, thank you, Gordon. I'm having a lovely time. Now, I'm going for a little chat, and then we'll go, shall we?
Yeah.
Or do you want the row here?
Flying a bit near to the wind there, aren't you, son?
Well, you'd have to, wouldn't you, if you had the chance.
But at my age, I'd rather have a bowl of scouse.
How dare you! I really dare you in front of everybody!
Marina, Marina, sweetheart.
Not bloody coming in, I can tell you that. You can sleep in a sodding car.
Shh, you're wearing the neighbours.
The sodding neighbours. I'm serious, Tony Kay. You're not coming in here. You can piss off.
Listen, bloody stupid.
Every night on the piss. Never knowing where you are, coming back all hours. It's not.
What did you say to her?
I told her I'd scratch her scouse eyes out as much as laid a finger on my husband.
Good thing you were polite.
Why'd you do it, Tony?
I just want to enjoy it.
I can't
can't stand much more of this here. I swear to God, I can't. Not bad. Not bad for a footballer.
Thank you very much.
Think it's past 3 yet?
I don't know. Why?
The cabin closes at 3. Drop me off if it's not too late.
What for?
Caesar. I don't know. Ringo might be in. Vonley. It's the only one I haven't had yet. About you?
I'm a phone to my bed.
It's your missus.
Aye, with my missus.
And your medal?
Yeah, probably.
Tell me, what happens next season, Mr. Football Man?
Don't know. Keep going, just keep playing football. Keep winning, I hope.
So when I go to school on Monday, I can say I've had Tony K. Better than Hank Marvin, I suppose.
When you're what?
What's that?
What's what? Listen, how old are you? I'm talking to you, how bloody old are you?
It's not your wife again, is it?
Oh, shit! Cover yourself up.
Hello there.
Evening, Constable.
What are you doing?
Biology. We're studying biology.
It's okay. My birthday was last week. I'm 16.
What are you doing?
What's it look like?
Where are the kids?
Next door.
Hey, look, I was on now.
The police rang. I want to know if you're leaving the Jag in the middle of the docks.
Oh. You know what that Gordon's like, eh? Me? You know what I'm like, baby?
I was waiting for you. I'm always waiting for you. I've been waiting for you for years. Waiting when you play football. Waiting when you go drinking. Waiting, waiting, waiting since I was 15 year old. And I always fall for it.
Don't, all right? I'll do anything you want.
Okay. Let's go home. Put in for a transfer, Tony. I want to go home.
I can't go back. Not now.
Dozens of top players implicated.
Good God, poor Jimmy. His balls must be hanging out to dry.
Is this Gabbett? It's got to be him. He's after all of us.
Oh, you don't know that, do you, Tony?
I'm telling you, Campion's a football man. It's this bastard Gabbett.
What happens if he comes after us?
What about Gould, eh? Will he talk?
Jimmy, of course not.
Oh, sure.
Maybe we should go and own up.
Own up?
Own up? Have you borrowed f***ing brains or what?
Just think about it. If we go to the league, tell them everything, we might get away with a couple of months' ban, maybe just one season.
It's a life ban! No exceptions.
Well, you can if you like. You'll not catch me crawling.
We threw the game, Tony.
You might have thrown the game.
I bloody saw you throw the game. You'd have been worse at throwing the game than you are at playing the bloody game. But I never threw nothing, right? All I did was have a bet.
You're in it like the rest of us. You knew what you were doing. You took the money, didn't you?
Listen. From now on, you keep away from me, right? Both of you. You don't ring me. You don't see me. We don't know each other. And that's the way it stays.
Hey.
Oh. It's you. What are you doing here?
Popped over to see Bronco and Swanny.
The kids are out. If you'd let me know.
It's just a spur of the moment thing.
Would you want to come in?
No, you're all right.
Hey, leave that alone for Christ's sake!
Phone the other day. There was no answer.
Well, I've been spending a lot of time at Gordon's, you know.
That'll be good preparation for new season. Will he be playing pissed as well?
Look, I'm not in mood, all right.
You look terrible, Tommy.
Better go.
When will we see you again, then?
I don't know.
It's only Yorkshire, you know. It's not bloody Africa.
He wasn't like me. He didn't need to do it. I did. He didn't.
Bit late, innit? Start thinking about football.
Let's do it.
You're a bit ragged-ass today. Everything all right at all?
None of your bloody business.
Sorry, I was just asking.
Yeah, well, I'm not in the mood for sympathy, all right?
You're not getting any.
Look, have you got out to say to me? Because if not, I'm going on.
People are talking.
About what?
Fixing matches, taking dives. Word has it there's players in the frame.
What's got to do with me?
You tell me.
Nothing. It's a lot of the bollocks.
Look, I'm not daft. I've been a player myself, remember. I know how it is. Bonus if you win. Bookies if you lose, cover your losses. But they're not going to see it that way, not nowadays.
Hey, Tony, can we have a word?
Can you handle him?
Of course I can.
Hey, Tony! Make sure you do, son.
Just the case, sir. Just
one more question.
We're
going to change, all right?
Yeah. But he's coming now.
Yeah, I started when I was about your age, probably.
Hello, Tony. Jimmy Gould.
Go on, boss.
What are you doing here?
I just saw Bronco. He said you weren't happy.
Did he?
Look, do you mind if... Well, I think it'd be easier if we talked in the car.
Listen, I really don't want to get dragged into any of this, all right?
You were looking for more money or something? Look, I really don't think we should talk about this out here.
Get him in the car, for Christ's sakes.
Don't be stupid, son. It's not worth it. You're not that kind of player.
Not that kind of player, eh?
See, there must be some kind of misunderstanding here, because the thing I don't understand is that you got your money from Bronco, right? I mean, I gave your money to Bronco for your bets, and he tells me he gave it to you. For throwing a game, you know, the game against Ipswich. Well, all I'm saying is that there's more money here, if you want it. Go on, take it. Take it. Square us up.
What's going on?
He's not having it.
Something's wrong.
I don't know what you're talking about. Trouble. Put a bet on when I was at Wednesday. Bronco knew this guy could get his good odds against Ipswich to lose. All the papers are onto it.
Tony.
I can feel him out there, you know, waiting to get me. But he's not going to stop. Till he's finished me.
What are you gonna do?
Just gonna see him all, you know, when I was a kid. Stanley Matthews, Finney, Rach Carter, and Shackleton. I wanted to be just like him. And I tried to walk like him. Do my hair, you know, slick back, Vaseline. God, they look fucking great. Nobody looks like that nowadays, do they? It's all gone now. I don't know what I'm gonna do.
You're so bloody proud, aren't you? You can't even bring yourself to ask me back. Frightened for years. Frightened he'd go. Frightened I'd lose everything. But now I have, and there's nothing to be scared of anymore.
What are you saying?
I'm saying I'll come back to help you through this. But I'm not promising anything after that. Okay.
Okay.
Tony.
Hey, leave this to me. This guy deserves some respect.
Go on, get him over there. Get him playing. I'll handle this.
Come on!
Hello, Tony. Pete Camplin, the people. Mike Gabbert. What do you want from me?
Give you a chance to have your say.
What if I don't want it?
Swan and Layne are talking.
We've got the statement, Tony.
We're printing Sunday. It's up to you.
We just want to know what happened that day.
Tell us about the changing rooms, Tony. Where you handed the money over. Used fivers under the main stand, was it?
Tell me you didn't do it, Tony.
You threw the game, didn't you? Saw your chance. Easy money.
Easy, eh?
Come on. Admit it, Tony. You're bent. That's the truth.
What do you know about...
Fucking truth, eh? You want the truth?
Hey, come on, come on, come on. A club comes to sign you when you're a kid. What do? They give you cash. If you're a pro, more cash. Bonuses for this, backhanders for that. Bookies, touts, hangers-on. You can't avoid it. So what, someone comes through, they say, hey, Tony, got a bet for you. Surefire. Good odds. And you're out there getting smashed to fuck every week. One tackle, that's it. So you take your chances. Everyone's doing it, no one's getting caught.
Yeah. I am, Ben. The old stinking game is. But you know what? At least I love it.
Come on, Camplin. Go where we came for.
You've broken my heart, Tony. You know that.
Now go and break mine.
Soccer Shame by Michael Gabbett, December the 1st, 1962. Soccer fans and all who cherished the good name of British sport should write that date in bold black letters. The day of infamy for British football. That was the day when the ugly cancer of corruption spread its evil growth right up to the highest strata of soccer. Association football is Britain's national game, the game we invented and gave to the world. And now it is our regrettable duty to report it is the game whose fair name star players like Tony Kaye have besmirched. Point new par. These disturbing facts first came to the attention of this newspaper more than a year ago. Disturbing facts which had to be made...
Boss, something I need to tell you.
Ron.
What?
When do I read about it?
Tomorrow morning.
Have you ever thought about why you play? I mean, really thought?
No.
No? Well, I'll tell you. It's all clear, that's why. You see, there's winners and losers, honest men and cheats, clear as crystal. Question is, what you do out there on the day.
But I knew.
I know lots of things. Off the pitch. Do lots of things. Never question them, close my eyes to them. Does that make me a bad man?
I don't know.
Okay, lad. Well, lad, long you go.
Go on. Give them some memories.
Do you honestly think people like all that kind of stuff?
Camplin, you know I don't like talking about politics.
Come on, answer the question.
Like it? They love it. They can't get enough of it. If you live in a grotty little council house and you work every day, you don't want to read about heroes. You want to read that everyone else up there is on the take. You want your cabinet minister shagging scrubbers, you want your film stars hooked on drugs, and you want your footballers taking bribes. The worse the scandal, the better you feel. Evens up the score for the common man.
You're probably right. On the other hand, you won't get your face put on a cigarette card, will you, eh? I'm not going to be able to tell my grandchildren about your magic moments. Here, souvenir for you.